Okay, good. Hi, Dr. Mark here for Natural Health. Hope you're having a great day. We're here again with our health shop tonight. This month, kind of goofy since we didn't have a meeting last Monday with Labor Day, this month is on degenerative conditions or chronic degenerative disease conditions in America. And tonight we're talking about general cancer information. Now, the thing is, in our office, once patients get cancer, if they diagnose with that, you know, we're working with the medical people. I mean, you have to treat it. You've kind of got yourself in a hole. You got to get back out. And we're not silly enough to not use some good conventional work too, but to get people to understand or try to explain how did they get there in the first place. You know, cancer just doesn't show up for no reason. Cancer is a degenerative immune system. The immune system is just not working right. It's not keeping the trash cleaned out. Lymphatics are full, the liver is toxic, all kind of things are going on here, so that the cells that are supposed to be making the body younger as they heal are coming out in a condition that makes them overgrow and do things not supposed to. That's what they call cancer. So the more those cells you get, the more problems the body has. They can overwhelm the body and things like that, again, because the immune system is not working right. So what we're going to talk about tonight is just some things you can do to help with that. Now, when in our nutrition response testing work that I do in the office, we get into specifics. And that's what you really want to do if you're in that kind of condition or if you have a family history, because you want to find out specifics. But tonight, I'll just give you a general idea of the things that really help in a general sense. So you can kind of look at these things and go, well, yeah, I'm not doing that one. I'm not doing that one. Well, I'm not doing that one. Yeah, so, you know, if you're not doing any of these things and actually, you know, eating bad foods and under lots of stress and around a lot of environmental toxins, you're just asking for these conditions, all the degenerative conditions, not just cancer, but all the other ones too. And to realize that anybody who has cancer, I mean, their body's not in good shape. They may have pre-diabetic, they may have, you know, congestive heart failure, all kind of things going on at the same time. But you're going to, of course, prioritize the cancer as it's a much more immediate problem to work on. So anyway, and we'll go through this information and talk more about things. So, of course, I'm Dr. Mark. We're going on 40 years here in the clinic, in the office. So we're looking forward to having an anniversary party. That's at the 40-year mark comes up actually in March of 2022. I graduated in October of 81, which would mean my 40th anniversary of being a doctor is here in October. So we're coming up that quick. So anyway, cancer prevention, optimizing vitamin D. Now you've heard that a lot around with immune system issues and the virus business right now, and everybody should be optimizing your vitamin D. And you don't really do that by just taking a whole big handful of D3 capsules. That's not really the optimizing the vitamin D. Vitamin D is a complex, it's a food, it's in the food sources. Good oils are how you get your vitamin D and sunshine. Of course, we've been told not to have sunshine because of skin cancer, blah, blah, but it's the chicken and egg thing. If you have good vitamin D levels, you can be in the sun all you want to, and it's not going to hurt anything. But if your vitamin D levels are low, and you're, you know, again, fighting all kind of other things, then yeah, you can have skin cancer, but it's not the sun that's causing it, because mankind's been in the sun for thousands and thousands of years. It's just in the last couple hundred years we've had the problem with the skin cancer thing. So anyway, optimizing vitamin D levels is important. And this kind of goes on with avoiding eating excess protein. Proteins are fine, but you have to be able to digest them. The same way with vitamin D, if you're not absorbing the oils that come along with the good proteins, and you can't digest the heavy proteins that are in like red meats and things, yeah, then they don't work very well for you. And you just sit in the gut and rot and putrefy. That causes other problems, of course, that lend towards colon cancers and things like that. So that's what we do at Natural Health, of course, with our nutrition response testing, is figure out how to help digestion. We usually work on detox first, cleaning the body of all the toxins and poisons, then secondarily working on digestion. An interesting thing I learned today watching a video, and I never heard it explained this way, but that the lymphatic system really is the largest organ in the body. 80% of your body fluids are in the lymphatic system. It's only 10% in the blood. So when the medics look at the blood for all their answers, that's not a very good indicator of how the rest of the body is doing. And we do a lot of work here with drainage, draining out the gunk, cleaning out the trash in the body. Like if you have a city and you leave all the trash around there where you're going to have rats, well, that's kind of what cancer is. Cancer is the rats. Cancer is the things that happen when you leave all the trash in there. And we got to get that all cleaned out, get the body working right again. Eating living foods with amazing health benefits. I mean, living foods are raw foods. And again, you have people to digest those. So a lot of people, old people especially, can't even eat salads because it bothers them so bad because they can't digest that kind of stuff. You have to work on getting that. Simplify your cleaning supplies. Getting away from all these toxic chemicals like Dawn detergent has formaldehyde in it. There's all kind of things out there that the chemicals, if you walk down the lane at the grocery store and you smell all this stuff, that's the outgassing through the plastic bottles of all these toxic chemicals. Really important to get away from that. There's other ways of doing that, a lot of simple things, but it doesn't make the manufacturers any money. So like baking soda, it's a real good way of cleaning things, but doesn't make much money for people. So you got to buy this fancy stuff with different colors and fancy bottles and stuff. Anyway, use greener beauty products, especially for the gals. All this makeup and hair stuff, that's a lot of chemicals and things. When you get away from that, you can find alternatives that work with that. And one thing I'll mention too is getting away from antiperspirants. Antiperspirants clog up the body's ability to detoxify itself, and especially the gals that are wearing a lot of the antiperspirants and now very tight bras, then the lymphatics don't drain, and they're just asking, again, cleaning, they're just holding all that trash there, and they're asking for breast cancer. That's two big causes of breast cancer, along with other things that we're talking about here. Ditch your nonstick cookware. The Teflon is a known carcinogen, and when you have your nonstick stuff and you're scraping it off into your eggs, whatever you're making in your stuff, you're going to eat that stuff. And of course, it's just good to stay away from. Good old cast iron skillets is about the best way to go. Stainless steel is not too bad, but you get used to doing cast iron, and it's not that bad. Drink clean, pure water. And what does that mean? Well, it means clean, pure water. It means not from the city water tap that's full of chlorine and the fluorine and those kind of things. You gotta find a good source of natural spring water. Spring water is about the best, really, because it's got some of the electrolytes and things, usually calcium and some of those things that are good helpers for the body. And that's probably one of the best ways. And you can filter water, especially if you're doing it. We have special technology we know of here at Natural Health we can talk to patients about. Choose organic and locally grown foods. You want to try to buy foods that you know where it came from, so that you know what was used on it. There's lots of chemicals used on foods, not only pesticides and herbicides, but also chemical fertilizers and things like that. Even colorings for certain foods in the grocery stores, like trying to make apples redder and try to make different things look better and all that kind of stuff, waxes and stuff like that. So it's just important to know, you know, what's going on, where the food comes from. Skip the canned foods. Again, canned foods, for one thing, they cook the heck out of them before they put them in there. That's why they're dead and they won't rot. They won't go rotten in the cans. And of course, the lining of the can, sometimes they use plastics, sometimes they don't, and it's just on the tin, and those metals get in there. You don't know if they've been heated or froze or what's happened to them. You don't know how long they've been around. So it's just good to stay away from those. Again, we want to try to get raw foods anyway, as long as you can digest those. Ditch your microwave. The microwave is very convenient. It's probably okay for a little warming, but it really destroys the food value. So really important to try to use a toaster oven. It takes a little bit longer, yes, but your food value is much better in there. And probably one thing I want to make sure to say about this, people that are even heating their food in microwave, is never heat the food in plastic. If you microwave plastic, you're just putting plastic oils and stuff right into that food, and you're just asking for lots of trouble. So that's a lot of just quick little things that you can kind of do a mental checklist on and see how many of those you're doing or not doing, and get an idea of what you're headed for. And of course, when we have our patients come in and we do their nutrition response testing on, and then go through a course of treatment, we're talking about all these things, helping them to relearn, you know, what's good, what's bad, why certain things work that way, like why a microwave is not good for you. So there's a lot of good things we do there. Also, most of the information that we talk about with cancer prevention works the same way with this virus business going on right now, too. I mean, a lot of people want to, in their mind, it seems simpler to say, well, this is a cancer issue, and then, you know, this guy's got a heart issue, this guy's got a diabetes issue, but really, they're all tied together. The body is one whole, not just pieces, just you want to treat one piece. That's the problem, one of the problems with the medical profession is, you have to go to this doctor for this problem, this doctor's a heart doctor, this guy's a diabetes doctor, this guy's the hormone doctor. They never want to talk together, and we have people coming in here on, you know, 5, 10, 20 different medications because nobody talks, they've on all this stuff, and it's just it's a disaster. So what we do here, we're looking at more of a holistic approach and using whole foods, the fuel the body is meant to have to heal itself, and getting away from the barriers that cause what it not to be able to heal itself. So again, cleaning out all these toxins and poisons, working on draining the lymphatics and all the trash out, and again, it just works very well for patients to be actually healthy, not just pain-free, our meds, our controlled disease process, but actually healthy. That's what we do here. So we're happy to help. Again, give us a call whenever you have questions. We do have free consultations for folks that don't really know what we do here, want to find out before they make any kind of commitment. So there's no strings attached. We just have a free consultation, and I'll talk to those folks about what we do here and what we can help with. So we're happy to help with that. And I think that's enough for me tonight. We'll let Dr. Chip carry on. Have a great evening, and Dr. Chip, you're up.
All right. Great. So we'll go ahead and continue the talk here. Of course, I am Dr. Chip. So again, like we said before there too, is cancer prevention is kind of the, or just general cancer is the topic of this this class or this health shop today. And a lot of times we like to think of just things being one way. But of course, there's always two sides of the coin. And so again, just like this coin here, again, a heads or tails, or just, again, two sides. And like Dr. Mark explained, is that a lot of times we put things in two parts, little categories for our minds to comprehend things. But again, we need to make sure that we're, or we could see it in a different way, saying that we can see the body as a whole, and that it's not really typically that we have a condition, it's more of the body is experiencing something in a certain way based on dysfunctioning systems of the body. So again, just two sides of the coin here. Now again, with cancer, one side of the coin is the actual cells that are cancerous. Now they have to, you know, kind of say, what do we do with the cancer cells? We attack them, we destroy them, we get rid of them. Again, just trying to take out the cancer, you would say kill or attack the cancer. And why, again, this is not a bad option, this is just another option, like Dr. Mark explained also, is that when you get to that point, you might need to take severe action, and that is kind of what this this kind of side is saying, is that you need to take some drastic action to prevent death, not necessarily to increase health. And that is not, again, a bad way, but there are other options, and again, there's much more, you would say, research and science backing up more ways of helping, and even thinking that these are just a few options, again, killing or attacking the cancer cells, is really that there's so many more options out there that we really need to actually help ourselves or actually get accustomed to being able to see that there's more information out there. So again, that's one way. It's like, again, attacking, killing the cells. And again, cancer is not a, you would say, a virus or a bacteria. Cancer is just abnormal cell growth. The cells of our body that are just abnormally responding to different things. You could say is that just like we'll talk about that here soon, I'm pretty sure. Now again, the other side of the coin is the body's systems itself, the body's defense systems. And so with cancer, again, cancer is just abnormal cell growth that is continually growing at a rate that the body can't handle. Now if the body is able to be, has enough of its, what it needs for proper health, then it doesn't get to that point where the cancer is overgrowing. Now again, we always have cancer cells in our body. It's just abnormal cells that are kind of out of line or not functioning the way they're supposed to. And typically our immune system is able to see that. It's able to make sure it's kind of ridding that or getting that out of the system so that it can function properly. So this kind of side of the coin here is that we're able to build up our body's own defense mechanism so that we're able to defend ourselves from anything like that. And again, it's just cancer, it's just that abnormal thing. And so like Dr. Mark explained, is that we like to put things into parts. We like to say that this is one condition, this is condition A, condition 2, condition 3, and all that. So what this side is saying more that our body is very smart, very intelligent, and that just kind of getting rid of things that cause the body to malfunction will help the body actually get enough what it needs to be able to defend itself. And so again, you'd say cancer is just kind of, you'd say cleaning up the cells that are not functioning properly. And then viruses or anything like that, that is just being able to defend ourselves from that so that it doesn't get widespread. And just like any bug or virus, we have trillions of viruses and bacteria and bugs on us all the time. And it's only until our immune system is not able to, you would say, control or handle the problem there, then that's what happens, that we have ill effects. So again, you would say is that the stress on the body comes from three different areas. You would say it's a physical or a traumatic experience. That could be either, not moving your body at all, not getting exercise, or moving too much, over-exercising, overdoing, because not resting the body can cause ill effects there too. And then like Dr. Mark explained too, nutritional toxins, that's important too, getting good healthy foods in, drinking clean water, making sure we're not getting so much toxic effects of the environment, and that we're able to clean up for ourselves too. And then emotional thoughts, very important there too, just because if we're always in a state of fear or different elements of frustration or anything like that, and we're not able to kind of help ourselves to come back to a good peaceful state, then that could actually cause a disharmony in the body as well. And so again, the like we said there too, chemical, food, water, and air, physical trauma, slips and falls, too little or too much exercise, and again, emotion thoughts is the negative. What causes an unbalanced body are these three kinds of stressors. And what happens there is that our own body's system is not able to harmonize or balance itself out. Now, there is a system called the sympathetic system, a system called the parasympathetic system, and it's kind of more of the fight or flight or rest and digest. And that's not saying that it's always best to be in this state or it's always best to be in this state, but it needs to be a balance between both of them so that we're able to go back and forth easily. It's only a problem when we get stuck in certain states. That's when our bodies are not able to handle different things there too. And so again, just like anything in life, we need a good signal. We need good connectivity. And if our body and brain we don't have a good connection with our phone to the satellite, we're not able to get clear directions, we're not able to get information that we want, that it's just not gonna be able to happen because our signal is not very well. Just like that, the brain and the body, the nervous system, all that, it needs a good signal, because if the brain and body are not in balance, if it's not getting the proper signaling, then all those systems and all those different things cannot function properly, and again, that causes abnormal functioning, causing abnormal cell growth, and the cycle goes on and on there too. And so that's why we need a clear signal, we need a good balanced brain and body to help ourselves in that area there too. And so again, like we said, chronic stress, the stress coming from those three areas causes unbalanced body, improper brain function causes dis-ease, Again, kind of similar to disease, just two sides of the same coin. Body system dysfunction equals disease. And again, immune system dysfunction coming from either the brain or body dysfunction causes cancer cell growth. And so again, that's just kind of a simplified version, of course. But again, a lot of times for some reason our minds like to think of very complex things, even though it could be very simple at a lot of different things. So keeping it simple is really more of the best way to keep things going there too. So I think that is it for the Cell Shop here. A little information here. This is To Health and Beyond. This is what Eddie and I have been working on. This is kind of more of a online approach to help people with their health and well-being in a course or platform direction there too. You can get more information at tohealthandbeyond.com. It's not quite finished, but we are close into the workings there. So that is it for tonight. You can always follow us at Natural Health Quincy IL at Facebook, Instagram, Parler, Brighteon, and YouTube. Our website is naturalhealthquincy.com. You can subscribe to our email list. We're located at 2000 Jefferson Street in Quincy, Illinois. The number is 217-228-2040. Again, thank you very much for watching. I hope that, again, it's not more of trying to influence you on ways of thinking. It's just really to get you thinking and help you to become more of a person that analyzes different information, and so that you can help yourselves or empower yourselves to help determine what is best course of action for you to take too. So again, thank you very much and have a great night.